don't say, honey, you're not gay, because then you're going to discount their journey and their understanding up to that point, and you just create a rift. So absolutely ask, say, well, what does that mean? You know, how'd you come to that? Because at some point, you know, parents separated and the child went off and investigated and learned from other sources of truth that they're gay. And so you're coming up against that truth and the authorities that are speaking into their life to come to that conclusion. So of course, come into it with an open mind. Don't fear, you know, the Lord will take care of it. So
for you, the experience of deciding you were gay, you didn't experience it as I was born this way, I've always been this way. That's not exactly what it was like for you.
No, what it did was answer questions that I had about my personality. How I express myself, where, you know, I'll tell you a small little story really fast, is I wanted a Cabbage Patch doll for Christmas. And when my sister and I would play house, all the dolls were girls. And so as a dad, I wanted a son. And I cried after Christmas because I didn't get a Cabbage Patch doll for Christmas. And my dad sat me down and says, look, boys don't play with dolls. So he had a rigid stereotype of what it meant to be a boy. And he didn't ask me, why do you want a Cabbage Patch doll? I said, because when we play house, I want to be a dad to a son. Now that I have a son, my firstborn son, like that was a nature, that was something that I wanted. And so the answer, homosexuality, answered, well, this is how you can relate and have intimacy with guys. I grew up with a dad that he said, quit crying. You're acting like a pansy. And so having emotions and connecting with men meant that you're a pansy, which is a 70s slur for gay, you know?
Right.
And so homosexuality answered some of the things of, well, look, I'm a sensitive person. I can be open and caring, and I have a listening ear, and I can empathize. And I was told that those kind of things were feminine growing up in school. And I was, you know, called gay. I mean, I was a peer mediator in high school. I was one guy among three other girls who were peer mediators for, you know, counseling. And so that was just who I was. I wanted to be a peacemaker, but wasn't received as a masculine trait. It was taught, and I perceived it, whether it was taught or not, I perceived that the giftings and personality that I was given meant that I was really gay and feminine. And so the gay community received me and affirmed all of that, you know? And so they had an answer. Well, you know, of course it was deceit and counterfeit and taking over.